Okay, so we're going to go through, I'm going to go through a series of some GD&T and some tolerancing creation through in 3DCS and in some CAD platform, KTV5. Our first one is going to be our new DLL routine called the draft angle or taper angle tolerance. You can find it in 7501. It is called the dcsTiDraftAngle. Very cool name. So when you go ahead and load up a tolerance, I don't think you'll have to have a DLL loaded like the X form or average tolerance.
You do. It's in the X form DLL, I believe.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it may be a part of the X form, but it's basically just a normal tolerance, same UI. I'm going to go ahead and load up the actual draft angle tolerance. So it's using that same UI. We have these two parts. Both of them have a draft angle. What we'll need is actual the feature that we want to deviate for the angle, and then a centered or a nominal surface, and then as well as a center point. We can use either a CAD feature or a point to define those. And then for a range, we can add a degree of variation. So right now, this model is actually really cool. It actually goes through and will take both of these cone-shaped parts, and it'll actually check, deviate the outside based on
The taper tolerance.
So when we add that tolerance there,
that's cool.
The bottom surface here is going to be the nominal surface. You're not going to see it deviate. If I changed it to the top surface, then this bottom portion of that surface will deviate in and out. Right. So it uses that angle to deviate the sides. And then if I wanted to, I can change the center. I can change the center to a point instead, like a dynamic midpoint, and offset it to the center. And then it'll take the center and then deviate from that center part, where it'll deviate this side of the surface and then the upper side of the surface.
Basically, that center point defines the bottom face or the vertex where your angle is going to originate from.
And I'm going to change it to -10. So I just add a dynamic midpoint, and then I'm going to switch that tolerance of that surface. There we go. Add center. Use that dynamic point. And then deviate. So you'll see it kind of deviate this surface up there and then down at the bottom here. I don't know
what just happened there.
Yeah, I don't know what happened to the feet, the mesh, but.
But you can see the walls are now tipping 2 degrees from the vertex defined by that dynamic midpoint.
And so just to give a little bit of extra entertainment, we actually added a move with some iteration, and it's checking the gap between the two surfaces. So once I go ahead and build it, it'll insert this part into the green part. And when I deviate, it's going to check. Oh, I probably should change it back, but it's going to check based on that measurement, the gap, and it should move up and down within that green surface. Let me change that feature really quick. Back to this point.
So it looks like you can select either points or features to define the vertex.
Correct. Speed it up to, there we go. So you can see this part is moving up and down.
I give it a sec. There's always a little bit of lag when you do live deviation.
Yeah.
There we go.
So this was developed for people that wanted to simulate draft angle on their parts. So if you're dealing with plastic parts that we know come out of the mold and they're designed with draft angle, if you wanted to simulate that draft angle, if the CAD was designed at nominal with no draft angle, you can put this tolerance on with just a constant angle, and we will shift the CAD to simulate that draft angle. And then it, of course, doubles as an ability to just add an angle tolerance on anything you want. We're adding it here on a diametrical feature or a tapered feature, but you can put it on any face.